Hi, I'm Oscar van Deventer, and these are the Soma penultimate variants. So you may have seen the three puzzles in the front before, and Volker Latusek developed a whole set of variants for me. Let's first start with these two, which you have seen before in my video, which had all pieces. But this one here, that's the Soma penultimate. When I made this, I needed a cheat piece like this to make things work. So when Volker saw my video, he said, well, you don't need the cheat piece. There is a better solution that uses the regular Soma pieces. So I'm going to demonstrate this to you because I really, really like the solution. So at first, it's easy. You take out one piece. After a bit of shaking, you take out another piece. Then we take out the gray piece. And from there, things are getting more complicated because nothing seems to move. So the trick is you push it upside down and then the pink or the purple piece goes in. You slide the blue piece sideways. And then we can move the green piece one step forward and up. Then we slide the blue piece down. The purple piece goes down and the green piece goes out. For the next move, we again need to move the blue piece up. Now we move the purple piece under. Okay, this requires a lot of manipulation. The purple piece under the blue piece. We move the orange piece and then the orange piece comes out. Now we have enough space to rotate the blue piece. And the blue piece comes out. And then a bit more manipulation to get the purple piece out. So this proves that for Soma penultimate, the puzzle is really solvable with regular pieces. But now let's go to the variants. And I'll just show you my two favorites. One favorite is this one with an interesting shape, where the holes are just three holes over the edge. This was a shape suggested by Jordi Gallen, but unfortunately it doesn't work. And together with Volker Latusek, we found a solution by making this hole larger that gives enough manipulation area for some of the pieces to come out as well. And this one again needs a lot of rotations. And another one that I really like is this one with the overhanging piece. Volker calls it ugly. And yeah, it doesn't look good, but it's very surprising that this U-shaped hole over the corner or over the edge, it works. And again, this is a puzzle which requires a lot of rotation and manipulation. And then here we have many more with all the different L-shaped holes, T-shaped holes, a hole at the corner, etc. So each of them has its own difficulty. They're all hard to solve, some extremely hard, some of them require a lot of rotation, so I can highly recommend them. So to finish my video, I have a question to you, and that is, which of all these variants do you like most? Thank you for watching.